Okay, so I'm sorry my back is to you. I don't want to, but I want to be able to look through this, okay? So, the Conservancy got $17 million recently for different fire-related items, and so I wanted to go through the different funding sources we got and answer any questions that might happen. So, I'll try to put through, and I'm going to try to reference the slide numbers for our people following along in Sacramento, so bear with me. So the first pot of money we received was a grant from Resources Agency for the Regional Forest and Fire Capacity Program.
Okay, I'm going to watch this.
It was for $1.5 million, and the primary goal is to develop a methodology for fire prevention projects within our zone that can be agreed upon by the different entities that practice fire prevention in our region. These are the basic guidelines. I know it's very dry information, so I'll try to click through, but if you have any questions, feel free to ask. The priorities of the grant is to research the existing plans and best practices in the region, to develop the methodology for the different types of projects that we want to implement, and then to do some demonstration projects across the region to show that the plan works. The grant that's on the agenda tonight, the MRCA, is for phase one. This is largely going to be research for the existing fire prevention plans that we have in our zone, and then outreach to determine the best practices and develop a consensus of the best approach for our region, including development of a draft document, so we have a starting point for everyone to provide comments. This is kind of the basic timeline. We want to do a draft program, some demonstrations, final edits, have the board adopt, and then hopefully be able to implement the program with continuous funding.
But that's not year, right? That's not like year five.
No. Yeah, that's okay. Not 5 years. Okay. No.
Yeah, I wonder what the timeline was.
You know, we need it very quickly. The due date is March of 2022, but I think we're shooting for faster since we all know there's fire need. The other fire aspect that we have funding for is for the Woolsey fire response, and we actually have three different funding sources that are for different purposes in response to the Woolsey fire. So there's FEMA and the Cal OES, the emergency money. We have DRIOA funds and then general fund appropriations. So I'll go into detail for those three categories. The first one is FEMA and Cal OES. I think a lot of you are very familiar with that. When the state emergency is declared, you can receive funding for costs. The tricky part for us is it covers the dates of the fire and not after. For us, that meant that there was a lot of activity that happened after November 25th that is not covered by FEMA or Cal OES. So that's when I went to our friend Joshua at Natural Resources Agency, and he told me about DRIOA, and I had no idea what DRIOA was. But apparently it is the Disaster Response Emergency Operations Account. And so with the assistance of Resources Agency and Department of Finance, we were able to get the $500,000 appropriated to the Conservancy to pay for those emergency services that MRCA provided for us, especially with the subsequent storms. So we had these burned areas and then these massive storms that resulted in some pretty catastrophic damage. And so just a lot of help from Resources Agency and Department of Finance in getting these funds to us. And so those funds cover everything from the date of the fire through October, although I think we have well over $500,000 in expenses already, but that was to allow for if there's a late bill or something like that. I also want to point out, it says payment is to the MRCA is pending, but we actually deposited it on Wednesday, so that is done. and then the $15 million general fund. So again, with help from Department of Finance, from Resources Agency, and the various electeds that have helped us through the budget process, the Conservancy was appropriated $15 million of general fund to provide public safety related to maintenance in response to wildfire damage. So this is the Woolsey Fire perimeter. I thought it was a cool map because it goes from green to red. And these are the MRCA and SMMC properties that are within that perimeter. And so you can see we have a ton of properties affected. Not that that's a surprise to anyone in this room, but I just like seeing that. So here are some of the photos and the information that was provided to Natural Resources Agency and Department of Finance while going through this process. So I'll try to click through, and I don't know all the properties, or if you have any questions, feel free to shout them out. That was up in Las Virgenes. And so this is one of the preventative measures that MRCA provided for these properties. They're not covered by FEMA, but they were necessary to keep the public safe, especially around these properties once they burned. So here's some of the examples where we were just trying to protect people, burned out trails. And I'm sorry if I'm going fast, I'm trying to not overwhelm everybody. But this is the example of the mud and rain damage after the fires that was so catastrophic that FEMA will not cover. And it's catastrophic. So we're gonna
Why won't FEMA cover? Because there was no declaration.
Yes, so the FEMA category covered the dates of the fire. And so because these storms happened after the fire, but the storms were not declared, FEMA doesn't cover the damage from the storm. Which is why our friends at Resources and Department of Finance helped us out. A lot of mud and a lot of damaged roads. We were trying to find some before and after, so you can see with the Weintraub property, Ramirez Canyon. Liberty Canyon.
So the money will finally get our Ramirez files in order?
we can only hope, right? Star One Trailhead and Corral Canyon. I know you can read, I'm telling the Sacramento people where we are. ULB. We also had a lot of damage with the impact of the wildlife, and so there was a lot of cleanup related to that, and just a lot of restoration that needs to be done, so we wanted to make sure that we emphasize that as part of our efforts as well. And a lot of irrigation, some of our sewers melted, and the fire lane damage. So this is how we propose spending that $15 million, 2.5 of it. We had to our support budget for two staff members to help in contracting and administering these projects. We want to do an assessment of the damage, and a lot of that is just that assessment and actually getting to these properties and seeing what needs to happen. Recovery, and then a restoration and stabilization. And so we broke it down into those three categories. The first grant that we're awarding is a $2 million grant, and it's going to be kind of a combination of the assessment and recovery to make sure that we make properties as safe as possible before we get into the next fire season.
What about lands that are adjacent to ours that are not ours? Was there money that went to like national parks?
Microphone.
Sorry. Was there money that went to other agencies that own land that's adjacent to us that also had damage? And are we coordinating the cleanup efforts and recovery and restoration stabilization with those agencies, and they have their own funding? How does that work?
So I'm not aware of all of the different agencies that have funding or how they're proposing. I know that for the agencies that we work closely with, we've been working together on those properties, and Rory and Paul can fill you more on those, but I don't know the general, how all the other agencies are distributing.
And this is kind of what we've been trying to handle in the meantime is stay on the trail. I'm sure you've seen these very pretty signs. But we also just want to make sure everybody stays safe while we develop these assessments and these plans, especially for project and site-specific plans that will be coming forward with more details for those.
Actually, I did.
And so that's just the summary of the different fire-related funding that we're doing. Again, thanks a lot to Resources Agency and Department of Finance for helping us get these funds. And if you want to be involved in developing the fire capacity program, or if you want to have those updates on the Woolsey Fire stuff, we're happy to report and bring you whoever you want in on that. So that's just my brief overview. I'm happy to answer questions.
You showed on the map the various properties that were damaged. Do you know how much acreage that was in total or close to?
13,000.
13,000.
Thanks. Any questions or comments? Thank you for a very thorough